Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we're going to be talking about how to dress as a nursing student and as a future nurse. And the reason why I want us to talk about this video is obviously there's a lot of things that I've seen that are like really big pet peeves for me. And also I've been doing a lot of research on, you know, the history of nursing for an upcoming video or a video that has come out already. I don't know how this order of these videos is gonna happen, but anyway. And like, I've just been realizing that there's a lot of prominent nurses that worked really hard to bring the uniform that we have and for nursing to be recognized as a profession and for it to have the caliber and status that it has. And for me, I just felt that if we do not dress properly as nursing students and nurses, we are pretty much just insulting the people that came before us who fought for us to have the nursing uniform that we have and for us to dress the way that we do. So in this video, I'm just going to be highlighting the most important things that you need to note when you are dressing for work, because you are representing the whole profession as a whole and yourself additionally. So obviously you want to be presenting both parties in the best possible light, because if you were to see someone like, let's say, the president come up and give a presentation to us and he's just dressed however he wants, we are really not going to look at the president positively, and we're not going to think that he can do a great job because he's dressed unneatly. And it's the same thing that we are advertising to our patients. As a result, it is important that we learn how to dress. If you already know how to dress, well done to you. This can just be extra points that you can take for yourself, or you can just share it with everyone else and give them a side nudge that, hey, we need to be dressing properly as nursing students. So without wasting much time and me blabbering on about the history and all of that, let us get into the video. So I'm going to be doing this from the top going down. So the first thing is obviously the hair. And this unfortunately relates to people that have got really long hair or long extensions and all of that. Please make sure that your hair is always tied up. Avoid having it in your faces. So if your hair is as short as mine, I would say it's still fine, because when you bend down, it doesn't go into weird crevices and poo and all of that jazz. But if your hair is like really long, like at least from here downwards, then your hair is really long and you should tie it up at the back. And please make sure that whatever hairstyle you're going to do, it doesn't require you to adjust it or constantly be maneuvering it so that it's out of your hair and all of that, because you really do not want to be in the middle of a sterile procedure. You're either putting a catheter or you're dealing with wounds and your hair just decides, now this is the time for me to unbraid, or this is the time for me to just go into the wound and all of that. It's really unhygienic, and in most cases you're going to be taking diseases, illnesses, viruses from the patients to yourself or vice versa. So please make sure that your hair is tied up and neat. It must be as comfortable for you as possible. The next thing is we're going to deal with the face makeup. Please avoid having extravagant makeup and like extreme colors, popping eyeshadows and all of that. You're just drawing unnecessary attention to yourself. We really want to be as minimalistic as possible and just blending with everything, with everyone. You really don't want everyone to point out at you like, oh yeah, that nurse with a bright eyeshadow. Don't do that. It's just unnecessary. So minimal makeup, you know, a little lipstick, you know, mascara to obviously look alive, because with the 12 hours just, we can look like dead people and all of that jazz. So just something minimal, but please do not overdo it. And then coming to our earrings and jewelry, have simple studs. Obviously I can't show you, I don't wear earrings, but simple studs. Don't have anything that can hang loose. And with your necklaces, if you really really need to wear your necklace, please make sure that it's tucked into your uniform so that it doesn't dangle out, because the danger with this is if you're working with aggressive patients or where you are working with small babies or just anyone in general, it can be grabbed on, you can pull out your ear. Because I know in netball, if you played netball, you know the stories of people pulling on your earrings. So use the same principles. Do not have anything that can be grabbed on or can go into, obviously can go into things that are meant to be sterile or things that are dirty if it's dangling down, or can get hooked on a blanket or something like that. So just avoid anything that's going to cause you injuries. Okay, and then I'm going to deal with the uniform from top to bottom by itself. So let me just deal with everything else. And then with your nails, please make sure that your nails are short because you can actually keep dirt under your nails. Also avoid fake nails, acrylic nails, or putting any colors because you might not even see that your hands are dirty because of the color that you have. And actually your acrylic nails can actually harbor dirt under them even though you're washing your hands because of the extra layers that it creates. It can actually keep dirt there. There was actually tests that were done where people were finding like microbacteria that is actually really dangerous to you under your nails. So just avoid it. And if you really do want some color, a clear one is fine. Overall, just make sure that it's clean and it's short. And then we're coming to our uniform. So the uniform would depend where you are in the world and the type of dress code that you have. So whatever dress code your university has, obviously stick to it. But in a South African context, it's obviously a white shirt with navy blue bottoms. That's either a skirt. If it's with a skirt, you need to wear black, navy blue, or skin color stockings. And if you are wearing pants, you need to have it with navy blue or black socks. And I know that's very specific, but if you're still a nursing student, whenever you're doing your procedures and your OSCEs, they really do look at those things, and you can actually get marked down regarding that. Obviously, the higher you go, the longer you're nursing, you know, things become a lot relaxed, and they really won't check the color of your socks and all of that. But you are still a nursing student and you get marked on it, so just avoid losing marks and just do the correct things. And then with your shoes, make sure that it's black or navy blue, it's closed, and there's no holes. And the reason for this is a lot of things fall: blood, stool, vomit, urine. A whole lot of things can fall on your feet, and trust me, you really do not want to be having blood seep into your socks, and you can feel it. And if you have a cut, you can get a virus and all of that. So just avoid those things for yourself, and just make sure that your shoes are closed and that nothing that falls will actually go on your actual skin. Your shoe, you can remove it, wash it, and life moves on. And then with your uniform, make sure that it's not tight. Like for me, I would say the golden rule is you must be able to run in your nursing uniform, because when those emergencies come, you're literally going to fly in the wards. And especially if your hospital has those long corridors and you've got an emergency, you're doing a resus, you're gonna have to literally run. So you must be able to run. Your uniform mustn't obstruct your movement, because in nursing you're going to be bending down and being in weird positions. Also, please make sure that the backside, no one is going to be distracted. We do not want to be seeing your crevices, and if you lift up your hands, we don't want to be seeing your abdomen. Just make sure that you're properly dressed, so make sure that it's comfortable and does not obstruct you. And the last two important things is your epaulets and your name tags. These are your distinguishing features. According to SANG, you're meant to have it. If you do not have it, it's illegal, because every single health professional that you work with and every single patient that you're working with, they need to know the type of rank that you are, whether you're a student, a professional nurse, staff nurse, etc. And they need to know who you are by name and year level if you're a student, because the patient has the right to know who is treating them. As a result, they need to be able to look at your name tag and say, okay, this is so and so who is treating. Obviously, you need to introduce yourself to your patients, but in case you forget to introduce yourself or things are just busy and you forget to mention it, they need to be able to see the name tag, because if anything goes wrong, the patient has a right to report it, and they need to be able to provide the name of the patient or the name of the person who was treating them and all of that jazz. So it is very important that you always have your epaulet and you always have your name tag. And the very last thing is obviously the things that you must always have with you: watch. You can either have the wrist one, or you can have the thing they call them the flop watches, which is the ones that are on your shirt. Whatever watch you're going to be having, you need to make sure that it's got a second hand watch or it's got seconds on it, because you're going to need it to count your respirations, your pulse, your contractions, and all of that jazz. And if your watch can provide you with the date, the time, and the day, and all of that, that's obviously extra information just to prevent you overthinking when you're doing your documentation. Then obviously you need a pen. You can get those nice ones that have got multiple colors. Those will really help you in your documentation to highlight certain things things. Like if you need to write a patient as a certain allergy, you can write it in bright red, bright green, whatever. Those ones really work magnificently. Please make sure that you have a thermometer. You're going to be popping thermometers everywhere, wherever, whichever patient you can be dealing with. So you need to have your own one. You really do not want to be running around asking people for thermometers. And most importantly, scissors. You're going to be cutting a lot of things, or things need to maneuver, opening packs and all of that. Please do not open anything with your mouth ever. It's very unhygienic. It's gross. Please have a scissors with you. And then you can have either stickers or you can have tape in case you need to label something. Then you can just use it to stick it down. But that's not really necessary. But the first few that I mentioned are really important. So I really hope this video will help you out so that you do not lose marks while you're doing your OSCEs for improper dressing, but also in general just to keep the nursing profession at a high standard with the way that we dress. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, definitely comment down below. I'd be more than happy to answer them. Until next week, Friday, 12 p.m. South African time, have an awesome day. Bye guys.